Welcome this evening. I invite you here to my house. I'm here sitting in my dining room, and I invite you here into this space as we go through this evening of Monday, Thursday, where we remember the Last Supper of our Lord with his disciples. And it's a little bit different, of course, than we're used to. We're usually gathered in a church. Doing some traditional things like a hand washing, maybe, and a foot washing before we gather around, listen to scripture, and then share communion together. But today we will be sharing communion together virtually. And I ask that you prepare yourselves for this time. Let the distractions be put to the side. Gather around with your family. If you're able to, gather around a table. I'm inviting you here to my table as we gather together. So gather your family around. Gather the things that you will need for communion. If you have bread or crackers, please get those prepared and put those in front of you. If you don't have grape juice, do use a substitute of, as you see fit, of water, another type of juice, or wine if you prefer. But get those prepared. And you can prepare those as we now gather in prayer and we prepare ourselves for this time. But it's also a time of celebration also after this week, that we can still come together here, right? We can still come together as one and as a family. So as we gather here today, let us hear from the scripture, the Holy Scripture of John 13, 1 through 10. It was just before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The evening meal was in progress, and the devil had already prompted Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal. He took off his outer clothing and wrapped around a towel in his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel and was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." "No," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Then Jesus answered, "Unless I wash your feet, no part with me. Unless I wash your feet, you have no part with me." "Then, Lord," Simon Peter replied, "not just my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus answered, "Those who have had a bath need only to wash their feet. Their whole body is clean, and you are clean, though not every one of you." Now this is the word of God for the people of God, and we all say, Amen. It's been a changing time in our lives as of late, hasn't it? It's been a time for us to think about what is going on. Think about, where are we going? And it's been scary and maybe anxious. But the question comes, and we look back at this day and the Holy Week. The question is, but do we understand? You see, during that time, Jesus knew what was coming the next day when he went to the Last Supper with his disciples. Of course, the disciples didn't know, like we don't know what's going to occur the next day, but Jesus knew. He was going to fulfill God's plan and die on the cross for our sins the very next day. He didn't have to do this, but he loved us so much that he freely went to the cross, that we could have a salvation if we choose in God's kingdom. In the verses that I just read from John, we see Jesus getting up from the Last Supper and wrapping a towel around his waist. He then proceeded to wash the feet of the disciples. This is what a servant of the world would do in those days before people would enter a house or sit down to a meal. So the question comes, do the disciples understand what Jesus is showing him right now? Here you have Jesus, God made in the flesh, willing to serve his followers in whatever way needed, even with this lowliest of tasks. Do we understand that we need to serve also in the same way? Do we really understand that in our lives, that we need to call ourselves to the lowliest of tasks to serve each other? We are to serve in any capacity in our lives as Christians to glorify God's kingdom. You see, it may be hard, and we may not want to do it at times, right? We drag our feet. We don't want to maybe do some things that are hard, maybe witness or do something good for someone. But I ask you to remember the love that was shown from God through Jesus Christ. Take a moment and look with me deeper into the meaning of this passage from John tonight before we partake in this supper. Yes, we know the verses talk directly about the humbling servant attitude of Christ, with him wrapping the towel around him and washing his disciples' feet. And he had that servant attitude, and we need to have that described to us by John to show us what Christ was doing and what Christ was going to do and show the disciples on that night. But Jesus may also be saying in these verses that their dirty, grimy sins will be washed away from him also. You ever think about that? Maybe that was another metaphor or analogy of, I'm washing away your sins very soon. I am sacrificing myself for you. Jesus, remember, said to Peter, you do not realize now what I am doing, but later, he told Peter, you will understand. But Peter, what did Peter say back in those verses? Peter said, no, said Peter, you shall never wash my feet. And Jesus answered this, unless I wash you, you have no part of me. You see, Jesus here is telling Peter, you need to accept me in the washing of your feet, or you really don't know me or have a part of me. Jesus is telling us that we need to accept him. Accept him for his ways, and then we will have a part of him. Jesus was serving all of us as a servant that day. That's the picture. And he washes away all our sins before we enter the house of God. Imagine that imagery. Knowing what we know now, even though the disciples did not know then. The imagery of washing our sins away before entering the house of God. You ever think about that in that Last Supper? He was washing the disciples' feet to let them remember, I cleanse you before you enter my house. That to me is amazing when I really thought about that and the word imagery that John shows us in that moment. You see, he served his Father as our sacrifice for our salvation. He not only washed away the dirt from our feet, but he cleaned our whole soul from our sins. We do not deserve this, but it was given to us by the all-encompassing love of God. A God that never abandons us. A God that is always reaching out for us and taking care of us. Now, as our feet, or let's say our sins, are washed clean, our whole soul has salvation from really head to toe, right? So now hear the word from that, understanding that Jesus is there washing away the sins of the disciples by washing their feet from and having them realize your sins are washed away from head to toe, because Jesus then answered this, those who have bathed need only now wash their feet, their whole body is clean. You see, when we repent our sins, accept Jesus as our Savior, believe in his resurrection, and love in the way of Jesus, we are all washed clean. We are now reconciled with God in His kingdom because it is our choice, but it may not be the choice we know of everyone. And Jesus here continues on telling this story and this importance to then Peter, and he said, "And you are clean, though not every one of you." Again, he was hinting that we have a choice, but maybe not everyone will pick that choice. And remember what he said to Peter, "And you are clean, Peter, though not every one of you." Do we now, from that, understand we need to go out and serve any way that God may call us? It's hard to do today, right? We are sheltered here in place. Some of us are self-quarantined in our houses. We know loved ones that are sick in the hospital. We know loved ones that have passed. And it's very hard to go about the way we used to go about things. But we are called to be a people that pushes through with Christ leading us. We are called to do it in many ways, and you've seen many ways of people having drive-by birthday parties, driving by nursing homes, and still keeping the self-distancing as they get out to get their essentials, but to give that life to the residents. Supporting our frontline workers by beeping the horns or gathering at a certain time from their houses and hooting and hollering from their doorsteps. You see, nobody is going to bring us down if we just come together in ways to figure out how to do this now. Just like the lives of the disciples are about to change and the world and the people in that world was about to change. Yes, it was scary. They did also shelter in place because they were afraid. But they persevered. Just know Christ is with you. God is always providing. God is among us with those small joys. And this small joy is us being able to still gather together on Monday, Thursday to have this meal. Imagine if this was 20 years ago, back in the early 80s when there wasn't the internet and this occurred. We would not have been able to gather. You see, to me, when I think back how technology allows us to do things, God is providing and did provide for us now. It may not seem it, but He is. He's providing for our sorrow, our fear, our anxiousness. We just need to lean into Him. So let us be a servant to each other and care for each other like Christ. It is not just in the walls of our churches to do this. We're learning that really big now, aren't we? We're really learning how it's more than the church and the building, but being out and among and outside that building. Yes, we need to come back and gather one day and we will celebrate. But we should be celebrating every day outside of those walls by serving like Christ would serve in our own context and our abilities. We need to remember to humble ourselves like Jesus did as a servant. We might be doing stuff now we maybe don't want to do. We need to take the unconditional love that was given to us and show the ways of Jesus to others. And as you're thinking about that, throw likes out there. Comment. Let us join together. That's the other thing to humble ourselves. Don't be afraid. Comment out there right now. Show us how God is loving you. Throw those hearts. Throw those likes. It's another way of communicating, right? It's a little bit different. But we are all here gathered together, showing that unconditional love by gathering around this table. And here are three simple rules we can follow as we begin our journeys. And these three simple rules are really used now for us to guide ourselves of to do good in Christ and do good for each other. Do no harm. Do what we need to do with proper social distancing. Know when we need to go out and not go out, but still do essential things that need to be done and support the ones that are doing those essential things because they're having us all survive, either from providing food, medical services, but also the ones that are providing spiritual guidance, either through online or out there in the food lines with the people or doing ministry in other ways, but doing it safely, just making sure we do no harm and attending upon all the ordinances of God, which is the, I think, really means to me that unconditional love and grace to love your neighbor as you'd want to love yourself. So take a moment, I ask you at this time, dive deep and reflect not only on the question, reflect on this question, but do you or do we understand what it is to do and be like Christ, especially in today's environment? Do we understand that? But on that question, do you see the love of Christ all around you? Think about the moments with family. Think about the moments you've been able to help each other. Yes, there may have been sad moments where we've lost loved ones or sad moments of people being sick, but we can still be there. They know they are loved. They made us who we are. They are blessings in our lives. This is a time to celebrate and to live life courageously, to live life lovingly. Because remember what Christ did for us. We will all gather again one day around that great banquet table. Just like we are gathering now in a way. And I look forward to that day with Christ. So I ask you, do you believe? Believe. Do you believe? That's where we come into this presence. That's where we come together. And we can't do things today like we would usually do, and I like doing the symbolic foot washing because the importance of that and me serving you in that foot washing. But you see, to me, foot washing is a powerful symbolic response to the word dramatizing the servanthood of Jesus both on the night before his death and his continuing presence in the midst of us. You see, the alternative title for this day, as you've been hearing me say, is Monday Thursday, which recalls the new commandment, Mandatum Novum, which in Latin is in John 13:34. You see, the service may appropriately be called Monday Thursday when foot washing occurs in imitation of Jesus' actions and as a response to his commandment to love one another. In addition to foot washing, there is also maybe we feel more comfortable in hand washing. And that's where I come now to this next part of this time with you, is to that time of hand washing. I have a potter's urn right here to wash my hands before I partake in the meal. The holy meal that Christ has provided for us. I then take the cloth and wipe my hands, remembering and reflecting on Christ's humbled servanthood that he was providing that night before the meal to the disciples, to that lowliest of job to wash their feet. So if you have a moment, take that time. Imagine that. Maybe if you can, go get a small bowl, get some water as I continue to speak, and just wash your hands and prepare yourselves as we come to this holy table. So as we're doing that, I ask you to set your bread or your crackers, set your juice to the proper area. Let us now prepare ourselves with no distraction around us because this is an important time for us to get settled. And now let us come together in this time of communion because we are experiencing Holy Communion today in a new way. Though physically separated from one another, we are still bound together as a family through our baptism. As members of the household of God, we now join together virtually, yet still present to one another as we gather from across miles and miles wherever you may be joining us this evening. The presence is marked by our shared praises and prayers and shared hearing and affirmating of God's word, and now in our shared eating, even though we are doing this virtually. And now as we share in the grace of thanksgiving, each time, I want you to remember, each time I say the family responds, you will repeat back to me the response I have given to you. So hear that again as we go through this, when we share this time together. Each time I say the family responds, you will repeat back the response I have given to you. So let us now prepare ourselves. The peace and presence of our Lord be with us, so that we lift up our hearts. And the family says, we lift them up to God. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God, because it is right and always thing to do, not only now, but always, day after day. And the family says, day after day after day. We thank you, Creator God, that you made us into your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away, our love failing and our bodies diseased, you reached out to us again and providing healing and wholeness and new life. When the flood came and you provided the ark. When the plagues came, you provided safety. When the evening came, you provided a pillar of fire. When exile came, you provided a new song. Day after day, your love remained steadfast. And the family says, day after day after day. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in the unending hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might. And the family says, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. And the family says, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. And the family says, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is your son who came to preach the good news to the poor, release to the captives, and recovering of the sight to the blind. Freed the oppressed and announced the time had come when you would save your people. He healed the sick. And the family says, he healed the sick. He is healing the sick now. And the family says, he is healing the sick now. He healed the sick day after day after day. And the family says, day after day after day. And on the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread. He gave thanks to you. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you. He gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of your sins. Do this as often as you shall drink this. Do this in remembrance of me. Let us be now a community of healer and hope, givers as together we proclaim the mystery of faith. And the family says, Christ has died. And the family says, Christ has risen. And the family says, Christ will come again. O Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit on us that are gathered here. And on these gifts of bread and wine, let them be for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ, made whole by his witness, passion, and life. In this season of social distancing, may you remind us that we are never spiritually distant from you. We belong to your body, and the family says, we belong to your body. May the Spirit see us to heal and reconcile in Jesus' name. And the family says, we will heal and reconcile in Jesus' name. And now the Holy Spirit make us one in Christ, one with each other and one in the mystery to all the world. And the family says, amen. Let us now join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The bread here reminds us that any life, no matter how broken or sick or distorted, it may become and can be made whole again. The cup reminds us that any life, no matter how empty or lonely or isolated, it may become and can be filled again. These are the gifts of God for the family of God. And the family says, thanks be to God. I now ask you to take time, and I invite you to prayerfully partake in this holy communion where you are at, by whatever means you have. May you now take a piece of the bread. Take and eat. This is the body of Christ that has been given for you. Remember this. He is with us. This is the blood of Christ that has been shed for you for the forgiveness of your sins. Remember this as often as you shall drink this. Do this in remembrance of him. May you now pray in silence. Now let us pray after receiving this meal here together. Day after day, you give yourself to us. And two or three gathered in your name, in connection across miles, and in bread and wine like we did today. As we go from this gathering around your table, may we feel restored to your body, companioned by your people, and sustained by the power of your Spirit, as we witness to the healing and reconciling work through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our service here of communion has concluded. I just want to instruct you, if you have any bread or drink remaining, please consume all of that. Consume those elements. If you cannot consume them, please take those elements and return them to the earth, meaning go outside, throw them in your yard for the animals, or just pour the juice outside. It's been blessed. So if you cannot partake with it yourselves, please go take those elements of and put them back to the earth. I enjoyed my time here with you this evening. I look forward to our time together on Good Friday, even though it's a very somber time for us. But thank you for coming here to my house and joining with me during this time. prayers are with you. If you would like to lift up any prayers, please put them up in the comments and I will respond to them. So may the Lord bless you and keep you. May His grace shine upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.